here it comes. Sure is nice. Cheap 300 horse. I'll hopefully get this done, then run off that 14 acres of my beans down the road so I can get some wheat planted there tonight. I don't know if we're gonna plant wheat here. We'll probably use the Great Plains, you know, do that if we are. I'm already tired from working on this combine. I didn't get here till late this morning because my son Ben had a field trip this morning. Went to an apple orchard. He didn't get back from, my wife went with him too, so they didn't get back till about 11. So I had to stay home with the baby until she got back. So I got a late start. Happens a lot with kids. That's part of it. You don't get to do whatever you want when you want when you got kids. I've realized that. That Henniker sure made nice beans this year. I think it really helped a lot by slowing down our planting, which is the opposite of what everybody else is thinking now, the high speed planters and whatnot. But I used to plant about 7 miles an hour with that Henniker, but now I slowed it down to about 5.5 and we got a lot better spacing, a lot better emergence. Did a good job this year. Neighbors here, their double crop beans sure really look good. It looks like they got a little bit of a bug in them. The leaves are full of holes. But the double crops and sure look good. They cut their wheat plenty high and them beans are over them yet. I wanted to plant some double crops, but we didn't get our shaw off fast enough to get our double crops in. Maybe next year. Say it every year, but we never do it. Just never get around to it. Decided to take a little bit off these less rows. But I thought if you get 2 rounds, got a broken section already. Right here, and a broken guard. Right there, so. We will get that fixed. Which one is it? Of course it is. I don't have that one. Well, I better go see if I got the right guard.
Oh, we don't have that one with us.
Might be up there in the gator. But we'll have to see. Kind of dark, but beans are starting to get a little tough. But this field came out just about perfectly. If I had to reverse the head. Drive and hold the camera at the same time. Because it's no room for air. It's exactly 30 foot wide left. It's just too wide. Couldn't quite catch it off. Then get a rock. Size rock. You can definitely see where we put the new tile last year on this yield map. Yeah, right where that green line is, there's new tile here, but not here. So that made a big difference. Dump our beans here. Maybe. decent semi. Dad left the scale on, so we'll have to get in there anyway. And that's it. Slice of beans for this field. First field of beans for the year. We're done with this field here, and probably go do another one tomorrow. Maybe run mine and try to get some wheat planted in a hurry. It's supposed to rain tomorrow night, so maybe. We'll see. But, and the bin custom ag is going to come out tomorrow to cut the holes in the roof vents, because Dad, his sketchy idea, he said it was too sketchy. So they're going to come out and do that for us. And we got something new coming, or I think we might have to go get it. Let's get the semi unhitched, get hitched up something else, and go get it. But that'll probably be next week. So stay tuned. Combining again, we moved to my field over here this morning, which it's boring to watch us move, so I don't film that. Just moved semi, green cart, header, trailer with a head on it, and the combine. It's a slow process with two people, but we got it done. So into that ditch, and then they dipped it and got them all back out. So, pick them up again. That's a good one. These heads float a hell of a lot better than the old ones used to. This head isn't that new, but we had a 9500 before this one with a 20-foot rigid platform. That thing did not flex over anything. Trash in here. Alright, there's probably a bunch of sticks here. The tree fell out of the field. Well, we're still combining. I got a decent amount done. Got 14 acres right there, and then I've got 10 acres done in this field so far. But I think it could be raining here pretty soon. So we'll get cut short here. I'm cutting now are the ones I replanted in previous videos this spring. It's hard to really drive straight. There's not a row to follow. And it got real tall and kind of went down. So. It's kind of tiring running beans. It's really not. Having to run so close to the ground that still missing some. It's going pretty good.
Yield
decently, 65. But this field probably average 65, so that's pretty good. It tires you out. Waiting for Dad to come back from the elevator with that truck. I haven't heard from him. So, hopefully he'll be back soon because the grain cart's full. Tires look much better. He's getting a lot of green pods in the grain tank. The stuff I replanted isn't quite as ready. So, but it looks a lot better now. I tightened up the rotor a little bit and closed the bottom sieve. That seemed like it worked. Rained out. So, I think that's going to be it for today. It definitely will be it for today. I guess Dad has the ditch bank mower sitting down there. So, I guess I'll go get that and take that back to the farm because I don't have any wheels. So, alright. Thanks for watching, everybody. See ya.